Hello, Warfighters, War is Hell. Welcome back to Arma 3 Recon. It has been a long time since I've gone ahead and done a mission in this series, but I felt the urge to go ahead and do that. So here we are. This mission is called Recon's On the Way. There's a second mission to this, which I think might have been made before. Anyway, I discovered the second one before this one. And so there'll be two parts to this mission. And then, of course, we've got the next one as well, which I think will also be a two-parter. But our objective for this one is to locate chemical weapons that are located on the island. And of course, we're going to have to go ahead and destroy those chemical weapons. Dang, we're just about a minute in here and already I am spotting enemies. So I'm going to go ahead and bring everybody up online with me right here. We're going to open up on these guys in just a little bit, but I need to see how many of them there are. Now, it looks like it might just be a fire team, because I'm counting three. There might be another one that's coming down there. I don't know. Look down my sights here. Target acquired. Fire at will. All right, we're all going to open up now. All right, that guy's down. Hostile down. But that guy's still up. Ah, dang it, I'm hitting the brick that's in front of me. Down. All right, well, at least I helped out here taking these guys out. So we're going to move up in just a little bit and kind of see what they might be carrying, if there's anything of value. Oh, some civilian, I hope, over here is running. Yes. Guy might have just been scared of the exchange of weapons fire. Well, I shouldn't say exchange because we took them out. I don't think they even got a shot back on us. But I'm going to go through. I'm going to clear all of these buildings. Just make sure that nobody's in here as we kind of move forward towards where the enemy casualties are. You know, if anybody were to pop out here of any of these buildings and hit us from a position that we weren't looking at, I mean, we could get wiped out pretty quick. And one of the things that I do like about just playing random missions is you have people who make these missions, who will throw a whole bunch of different things at you. And so it's not like when you go through and you play a campaign and you kind of know what to expect. You kind of pick up on things as far as like what they're going to throw at you. It's different. It's cool. So going along the coastline over on the west was something at the very beginning they told you not to really go ahead and do because it is heavily defended. So I decided instead I'm going to go ahead and I'm going to take this truck. Yes, I am stealing a truck. And I'm going to head to the objective here. Now, good eyes on the part of my team members here. Because I think that's, let's see, 3, 4, 5, 6. That's got to be squad-sized unit here. So we're just going to hang out here for a little bit, basically, until they end up passing. So now I'm at the top of this hill, and I decided, all right, we're going to go, we're going to get out of this hill rather than just going up over the top and having no idea what might be on the other side. Now, it's a pretty big valley here. It's a good thing, too, that I didn't just drive this truck up over the top. You can see you got an APC on the road right there in front of us. And so we're going to have to cross this road without alerting that APC. So we're going to have to move pretty quick. It is moving slow, which is good. And it's got its lights on, which allows us to be able to see it easier. But I also don't know if I go down this hill, if there is going to be anything else that could be in our way. If there's some type of infantry patrol, we'll have to take them out quick. But I'm not spotting anything. And the APC came back once down the road. Now it's going back the other way. So we're making a really quick break for it. You can see, oh, never mind, I'm hitting a rock, but we're gonna go into this contact quarry up here. We're gonna try and hide out here once it passes, and then it'll give us more time to kind of go up over that hill and out of the way. So I timed it too, and we do have a good amount of time to be able to get into position and get into cover over here before the APC starts heading back this way. But I don't want to risk anything here, as I mentioned, and I want to make sure I kind of proceed cautiously. So again, don't see anybody in here. I can imagine they'd be out in the open, probably. But once we find a good spot to be able to get everybody, we should be all right. I think I'm going to go up here, and this is where I'm going to hunker down, right behind these rocks. I got everybody laying down, because I'm pretty sure that the APC is on its way back over here. But again, I want to get everybody behind these rocks up here, because that will definitely prevent the APC from spotting us if we're behind all this, too. We will have the advantage for sure of being directly on its side. And here it comes. Stop. All right, got to get everybody to stop. Yeah, we'll be on its side. So it'll be difficult for him to spot us from here. And we don't have anything really to be able to take it out either. Nobody's got anti-tank weaponry. We don't have any explosive charges that we could really use to put on the road to kind of make it act as a mine. Or any mines, for that matter. But I think if it were to have spot us, it would have done so already and opened fire on us, too.
Target in sight. Target in sight.
I know everybody's calling out for it here, but I don't want to open fire on this. Okay, we've been pretty stealthy. We're going to continue to try and be as stealthy as we can as we proceed to our objective. A lot of what we've been doing has been on foot. So there's a lot that I've had to kind of cut out, but it's really nothing eventful if I'm just sitting here walking around. But I come across this town, and as I look out over it too, I can imagine there'll be some enemies that are here. I don't spot any from this location. Get out the binoculars, take a look, and see, you know, just your standard type of stuff. Some ruined buildings. You got some vehicles. Oh, there is one, but where? I can't see him from this location. Like, I know he's on the map and everything. I could go out and try and figure out his direction based off of the compass and get a rough estimate, but I feel like this is good enough. Gosh, nobody. I might have to just take a chance and just move down into the city closer towards the contact that we have to meet up with. You can see he's going to be in a cemetery, and I don't see a cemetery around here either.
Machine gunner, 800 meters north.
Gosh, now so there's somebody else. All right, we're just going to move. And all the while, you know, I'm looking off in the distance and see if I can spot these guys. Yeah, I know my guys can see wherever these guys are, but the downside is I'm not going to be of any help. And I don't know if we have the better position or they do. So again, just kind of moving in here. These guys are 400 meters away.
Man, half a click north.
285. It's off over there. I feel like things are going to get hairy inside of this town. We've got no other choice. I don't know if we're going to be able to sneak our way past all of these guys, too. Oh, they're on that road. Okay. What I'll try and do is get in the second story of this building and see if I can get some eyes on that road and where the enemy might be. I might be able to take out these guys just by myself if I can get a good look. Got that tree in front of me, though. Dang it. And I don't see anything off over towards this side that I can really get into that will give me as much of an elevated position. I mean, I'd have to run across that road and go into a building. It's a lot of open space for me to try and get through. Okay, been sitting here for a while. And finally see some enemy soldiers here just kind of walking down the road. I feel like I got to take these guys out at some point. So I've got my guys just a little bit ahead of me. I should be able to do some good up here once we open fire on them, which will be soon.
Target acquired. Move 300 meters front.
All right. We're going to move them up just a little bit more.
Move 300 meters front. Weapons.
We're going to get them along this road too. All right, my guys have opened fire. So I'm going to also Well, that guy dropped, like, just right in, right on time, and in a position where it's going to be very difficult for me to hit him. Now, just hearing what's going on down below me here, that exchange of fire, they're definitely taking a lot of the rounds. I'm not taking nearly as much up here as they are. Taking a few more shots. This guy here. And since there's only four of them, we should be able to take him out pretty quickly at this point. Once we're able to do that too, we should be able to move on to our next objective. All right, taking these guys out. There's another one. That guy's standing out in the open. Got him. Is that everybody now? That might be everybody. All right, I'm going to go ahead and just... Oh, nope. There's somebody still out here. I'm going to move down.
Report in. Over.
Ah, dang it. I lost somebody. All right, that's going to make it a little bit tougher for me. Got three instead of four. But I can still proceed on. Okay, so now we're at the cemetery here. Got everybody holding fire because I know the contact here that we're supposed to meet up with is somewhere around here. So I don't want anybody to be accidentally shooting somebody or go ahead and start a firefight without me being the one who actually give the command to start it. Now, this particular cemetery, it's large. You've got some mausoleums too. You know, that are over on the left. I'm guessing that if he's not out in the open, we're going to find him in one of those. Yep, called it. Caught him in the window. Okay, he's not talking to me. Talk to me. Unless he's not the contact. Maybe we got to get everybody else over here too, so I'll just kind of move forward a little bit. There he is. Hello, Zorba. Could have told me that earlier. All right, so he's got a boat for us, or a ship. We'll be able to get to the power plant, which is it on the map? It says, give me your map, and I'll show you where the vessel is. Well, knowing where the vessel is one thing. I gotta get to it. All right, so we're on the move, getting to where it is on the map. It's through this city, and I don't want to go through the city. I want to go around it as much as possible. Now, my guys, hurry up. Get over here. We have to move pretty quick, but something spooked him here. Since they're still in combat mode, or they are in combat mode, so they're bounding from one location to the next. All right. Well, once I kind of get them here with me, start to press on just around the city. Thank you. Now you say the area is clear.
Man, 200 meters front.
Dang it. All right, there's somebody 200 meters ahead of me, so now got to try and figure out where it is. You call all clear and then say somebody's 200 meters ahead of you. Question is where? I'm scanning the area in front of me. I'm not seeing anybody at all. There's that one tower, of course, that's over to the right. And now I'm supposed to see him? I guess I could go to the map and try and see. Oh, there they are.
Target in sight.
All right, I'm going to take him out.
Fire at will.
All right, let's do this. All right, one guy's. Come on. Now they know where I'm at. All right, I took some down. Gosh, I had some bad aim to start that off. All right, same thing. We're going to have our guys just hold fire here. Oh, there's somebody down there on that road looking this way. I don't know if I want to try and get that guy or if I just kind of want to move ahead. We should be able to bypass him. But I'm going to keep everybody down.
MRAP, 400 meters, southeast.
Oh, that's a different story. There's an MRAP nearby. Yeah, that guy's on the move. Oh, there's a whole convoy over there.
Cover me. Truck, 300 meters, southeast.
All right, that's not good.
Man, 400 meters, northeast.
All right, let's get going.
MRAP, 300 meters.
Yeah, that looks like it's an enemy position. I definitely do not want to go any more to the right than I have to. Also, if I can get away from that convoy, too, that'll be important. All right, haven't spotted anybody. Continue to kind of move forward here, but I'm starting to hear some vehicles around me, so I got to be very careful on what might be around. Because, like, the last time we saw that convoy, they were behind us.
Machine gunner,
yep. I was right. All right, I'm going to have everybody just get down where they're at and hope nobody spots them. Like, my marksman right here, he's in a pretty good position, so he should stop. Because he'll be behind these rocks.
Roger that.
Three looks like he should be all right, too, but I think it might be too late for him to move. All right. Oh, yep, here they come. Staying low. I mean, he might have seen me already.
Inrat, 200 meters front.
They're going pretty slow through this. This ain't
ready
good. All right, staying low. Just let him pass. Oh, that guy's opening fire over at my medic. Now there's no more firing going on. I wonder if they killed him. Where are they going? They're getting off the main road.
Target acquired.
And then are they getting back on the main road? That dude just ran right into a light pole. Man, Arma needs to get better at vehicles. I know there was an improvement not too long ago. I'm wondering if that would have fixed this, because, yeah. That was not pretty. Okay, this seems to be smaller than what that convoy was originally.
Target,
so I'm wondering
inside.
If they split up. We get over here and take a look at three.
Three, sit rep.
Yeah, he's dead. Never mind, I thought he was on the other side of the stone.
He's hit.
Apparently not. Okay, it's just going to be me and four. So we've gone around
four.
The extreme right of the city. And we're actually not too far away from where the boat is supposed to be. Or actually, yeah, it was our right, but gone around to the west end of the city. Advantage, of course, the reason why I did this is one, having the ocean off to your right means we have to worry very little about any enemy off to the right, but then it's also an easier way to be able to follow to get to the boat because the boat's going to be on water. Now, this little hill, as we kind of get up and over this, should provide us a little bit of cover here with the trees and the rocks that are over here. We'll be able to see if there is anybody guarding the boat or any of this location around here. I'm not seeing anybody on this road, but I'm going to be very, very careful because we're getting closer to the city now, too. If I go just down here, I'll have some cover. So kind of move through here and get around. But yes, yeah, so we're very, very close to where this boat is supposed to be. As long as the contact gave us the right information, we should be able to use this boat to go across the bay here and get to the power plant, which is farther down the way. All right, I'm being cautious. I haven't seen anybody for quite a long time, so I'm kind of nervous that somebody's going to pop up. Yeah, nobody's standing up there.
I see movement. APC, one click, southeast.
All right, there we go. There's something around here, an APC. Though it being a click away, it's going to be hard for him to spot us, especially if we're staying low like this and also using buildings and the terrain to kind of mask our movement. There is that tower that's way up there. I'm wondering if that's kind of where the APC is. Haha, there's the boat.
Soldiers, one click, southeast.
Yep, soldiers a little bit off too. Okay, we're fine. I mean, that's all right that they're a click out. Sweet. All right, so we've got the boat. I'm going to get in the boat.
Get in that vehicle.
And then I'm going to get the only other survivor of my team here into the boat too. We're going to go ahead and we're going to make our way towards the power plant. And that's where I'm going to go ahead and end this first part here, is us getting to the power plant, where you have to prepare for the next part of the battle and this mission and take out those chemical weapons here. So thanks for watching, you guys. I sure do appreciate it. Remember, second part is where I'll go ahead and do the ratings on this mission. So make sure you guys subscribe if you have not already. You can find me on Twitter @_WarAsHell. And please donate to the Patreon if you guys also have the chance to as well. But thanks again for watching Warfighters. War is hell. But you don't have to worry, because Warfighters, I've got your six.